All right, we're looking at an anterior portion of a left hand, and you can see, putting my hand right next to it, this is going to be the lateral portion and moving more medially. So before we really get into the separate types of bones, let's talk about the digits and how we number those. When you're talking about digits, you start with the first digit. Your first digit is going to be associated with your thumb. So first digit is going to be lateral, which is different what you have in the foot. The first digit is going to be medial, associated with your big toe or your great toe. So different in terms of what you have in the upper limb than the lower limb. So first digit, it's lateral. Second, third, fourth, and your fifth digit's associated with your little finger. Okay? So we'll talk about the three main areas of bones. You're going to have your carpal bones right here. These are your wrist bones. There are 8 carpal bones. You'll have your proximal row and your distal row. The proximal row is made up of 4 bones, so that's what's actually articulating with the radius. So your radiocarpal joint is going to be the articulation of your scaphoid bone, your lunate bone, trichetrum, which is going to be the most medial. And sitting right on top of the trichetrum is this little bone right here referred to as the pisiform bone. Now the pisiform bone is not actually a part of your radiocarpal joint. It is going to be associated with your flexor carpi ulnaris tendon. So this is one example of a sesamoid bone. Another example, the largest of your sesamoid bone is your kneecap or your patella. So sesamoid bones actually form within tendons, so very unique in terms of their bone development. So this is your proximal row. These are what's articulating with the radius of your forearm. Then you're going to have your distal row of carpals, so also 4 bones. You'll have your trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, which is your largest of your carpal bones, and the hamate. And you can see this hook right here, the hook of your hamate, often fractured. You'll have a tendon that's going to be moving right through this region right here. So these are your carpal bones, 8 in all. Then you're going to have metacarpals. We think of the metacarpals forming a good portion of the palm of your hand. So your metacarpals are going to be here, your carpal bones, your metacarpals are going to be right in this region. Your first metacarpal is going to be the stoutest. It's also the thickest in this region. Your second, third, fourth, and your fifth metacarpal. The fifth metacarpal is an area of frequent fracture, particularly in terms of individuals that box. You'll have a fracture in this region. Now, one thing I forgot to mention when I was talking about the carpal bones is this, particularly in the proximal row, you can have fractures in this area. So you'll have the collase fractures, which are fractures of the distal end of the radius. Oftentimes, in association with that, you can have a fracture of your scaphoid bone. So your scaphoid bone, or the most lateral on the proximal row of your carpals, this is the most frequently fractured carpal bone. And actually, this has a lot of implications. If you get a fracture here, often it's not picked up immediately on imaging. Usually you'll go in for some type of x-rays. A lot of times you'll be misdiagnosed as a strained wrist. You could go back in a couple of weeks later, and because the blood vessel was kind of broken in that region, it could lead to necrosis or breakdown of the bone in that region. So often it's misdiagnosed, but with better imaging, this has been picked up a bit more. All right, so those are the carpals. Your metacarpals. Right here, you're going to have your metacarpophalangeal joints, so between your metacarpals and this proximal row of phalanges. So if I were to show you here what we think of as the knuckles, it's going to be these joints right here. So your proximal row of phalanges, you'll have 5 of those. So your first, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Your intermediate row, so you're getting a little bit smaller, you're only going to have 4 intermediate or middle phalanges, and it starts with the second digit. So right, these are intermediate phalanges. So note, I just said that we do not have an intermediate phalange associated with your first digit. Now, in terms of the last row, or your distal phalanges, these are very unique shaped bone right here. So you have 5 of these. You have a lot of sensory nerve endings in this region. So if you think about closing your hand in a car door, how painful that can be, it's because you have so many of those sensory endings associated with this region of the bone. So you have 5 proximal phalanges, 4 intermediate phalanges, and 5 distal phalanges. So this is why you have 14 bones associated instead of 15, because you're missing this intermediate phalange here.